The opening paragraph on this section in Doug Stone's book, Metal Detecting for Gold in Australia, is pretty black and white. It simply states that, and I quote, "The coastal goldfields stretching downstream along the Clyde River through Nelligen into Batemans Bay estuary and gullies surrounding Mogo carry gold." Okay, so Doug's research has confirmed the presence of the precious metal in the Batemans Bay area. Batemans Bay is a beautiful coastal township about 3.5 hours drive south of Sydney, surrounded by picturesque mountains and valleys. It's worth a visit anyway, but the story of gold and this region taking in places like Braidwood and Nowra is a different story to that so familiar in terms of the gold rushes associated with Victoria and other parts of New South Wales. Although gold was first discovered in this region in the 1850s, making it one of the earliest gold discovery locations in the colony, the search for gold would involve painstaking work, seeking alluvial deposits, rather than stories of diggers virtually tripping over the big nuggets, sometimes found in other parts in well-known goldfields across the colonies. The level of difficulty is reflected in the fact that so many Chinese diggers worked this area. The Chinese were well known for their industrious approach to mining and their willingness to work areas otherwise deserted so often by other diggers. Nearby Mogo was reputedly one of the richest areas in this region, with many gullies offering diggers plenty of fertile ground for uncovering gold in those early days. The Batemans Bay region is richly endowed today with national parks, and many of the gullies and the mullock heaps left behind in those early days have virtually been flattened by logging or overgrown with the luxurious tree ferns and other flora that flourishes in the area. Today's prospectors, armed with their state-of-the-art metal detectors, may well find it worth running those detectors over some of the ground that has largely remained untouched since those early efforts to recover gold. This region is fed by many streams and tributaries, and there are plenty of areas running along creek beds where prospecting today is permitted. Whether you're panning beside a stream or running your detector over the remnants of mullock heaps and riverbeds, the area offers plenty of scope for prospecting and generally enjoying a beautiful part of Australia. This part of Australia is rich in history, natural beauty, and has many reminders of past generations with architecture and plenty of tourist activities. Check out Doug Stone's Metal Detecting for Gold in Australia and the many New South Wales online tourist resources. And remember that line in Doug Stone's book, "These coastal gullies and fields carry gold."